Chris Cook for you too. Today, when it's cold outside, like it is here in Virginia, you may want to do a dish that's very hearty and filling for your family. So I decided to do my country chicken pot pie. So let's get started with the ingredients that you're going to need to make this awesome meal. You're going to need milk, chicken stock, minced garlic, bouillon cubes, crescent rolls, butter, flour, salt and pepper, celery seeds, mixed vegetables, and of course you're going to need the chicken. Now I have chose to use chicken breast because that was all that I had in my refrigerator, but you can use any parts that you like. I would prefer to use chicken thighs because they're juicier, but I didn't have that, so I'm going to go with chicken breast. So what I'm going to do is to go away. I'm going to grill this chicken up on my George Foreman. You can grill it up, you can broil it, you can boil it, or you can just fry it, however you decide that you want to do. But if you're going to fry it, don't use any flour coating on it. So I'm going to go away and prepare the chicken and get ready to put together this dish. One other thing that you're going to need is you're going to need a baking dish. And the baking dish should be buttered. So when I get to that portion of it, I will have it buttered. So I'm going to go away, prepare myself, and I'll be right back. Okay, I have everything together to mix it up, but I just wanted to show you how to lay the bottom half of the pastry inside of your buttered dish. Now, here I have a buttered dish, and I told you that I'm using crescent rolls. I like the taste of the crescent roll. Now, a lot of people would say, you know, you can make your own dough. Yeah, you can make your own dough, but sometimes, if you want to go through that long process, but sometimes it's just easier to buy a brand that you know is actually a good brand. And I feel like this is actually a good brand. And a lot of times, you know, it's not that something homemade tastes better than something in the store, because something in the store can very often taste better than something homemade. It depends on who's actually doing the cooking. But anyway, we're going to put this, we're going to layer this into our pan. Now you see these perforated holes in it where you would separate. We're not going to separate, and we're not going to worry about those perforated holes, okay, because that's just going to help for your pot pie to breathe while it's going through the baking process, okay. So we're going to go ahead, and sometimes it comes out cut and sometimes it don't, so I'll just cut it. Okay, so put that over there. Okay, now I have already put a little flour down. As you can see, the flour, I put a little flour down on my cutting board because I wanted it to be easy to get up. And so I've just layered my three pieces here together. Kind of put them together a little bit. And I have my rolling pin out to flatten them if need be. So I'm just going to roll this just a slight bit. And all I'm trying to do is to just spread it out just a little bit. Okay, now it's, my table is granite and you can't just sit something down on it, okay? There you go. So I've rolled that out just a little bit because it'll slide backwards and forth. Okay, so I have this together. Now I'm not gonna worry about this perforated line that you see here. Like I said, that's just gonna help this dish to breathe. So I'm gonna go ahead, and this baking dish is oversized. So this is not your 9x12, because you know, as I always tell you, I'm feeding a lot of people. So this is gonna be just a lot, a little bit larger. So I'm gonna go ahead and place this in my baking dish, okay? Okay. And you're going to bring it up the sides if you can. And you can just press it up your sides. Okay. Now down here, I can get it up. So I'm going to go ahead and take it up. Now, remember I had another half a piece left because I only used three of my perforated pieces. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this in half. And I'm going to bring this, roll it out, and I'm going to bring it up my sides. Okay? Now, this is real simple. I have 4 cans of crescent rolls, and the reason being is because I'm using an oversized baking dish. So I have 2 for the bottom, and I have 2 that's going to go on the top to help bake this off. Okay? So all I did was just put them together, like you see me here, and I pressed it in place. Now, you don't want to leave real big holes. See, if you got a real big hole, you want to kind of bring it together. You don't want to leave real big holes, but you want to leave them big enough so that your pie can go ahead and breathe. Okay. So now that I have that side done, I'm going to take the other side. And if you see where some of it is not meeting, just go ahead and put it together. I'm going to take this, unroll the other side. And I'm going to put the other side right there. Now, on this side, I'm going to overlap it. And the only reason why I'm going to overlap it is because I don't want any space, which I should have did the other side, but don't really matter. See, now I don't have a space between the sides. Because I just went ahead and overlapped my sides to my bottom. So that I made like a wall. Okay? Now, once you get this, and you can do it a little bit more to perfection. Okay, once you get this all done, you're going to wait for the next step of it. Okay? So now, I'm going to meet you at the stove where I had a little piece left. Just taking the sticker right there. Okay. Now, you don't have to be perfect with putting this in the bottom because you're not going to see it anyway. Only thing you want to do is make certain that you have the bottom covered. So, I have my bottom covered, and I'm going to take this and take it to the stove so that we can put it, the rest of the mixture in there. Now, I'm going to bake this in a 425 degree oven for roughly 30 to 35 minutes until my top is golden brown and my bottom is bubbly, where I can see the bubbles coming through on the side, and I can see the bubbles because this is a clear dish. You can see it that way, but you can tell it anyway because you'll see bubbles right around the side of it. So I'm going to go ahead and I'll meet you at the stove. Be right back. Now, okay, I'm back, and I've already put my vegetables in the bowl that I had, and I'm going to put the measurements at the bottom of the tutorial like I always do, so you'll know how to do it if you're doing a dish that's a 9 by 13. Okay, so I have my vegetables, and these are frozen vegetables. I have them already in my bowl. Now, I had some leftover, because we all know the pot pies are mostly made from leftovers, so I had some leftover cubed potatoes, so I'm just going to go ahead and put in the cubed potatoes that I had that was left over. Okay, stir it up just a little bit. And I'm going to go ahead, I cubed up my chicken, and I did do my chicken on the George Foreman. And as you can see, it's just cubed up. So I'm going to go ahead and put in the chicken. Put in the majority of it anyway. Okay. Now I've done a little mixing with that. Now, over on this side of the stove, I have my butter that I've melted in a pot. Don't burn it, okay? So that's my butter that I melted in the pot. To that, I'm going to add my black pepper, my celery salt, or celery seeds, my regular salt, my bouillon cubes, and my garlic. Okay, now I'm going to stir that, okay, and to that mixture, just kind of mash it up just a little bit, I'm going to start to gradually add my flour. Okay, now this has to come up to a boil, but I'm just going to let you view it while I put in the ingredients. Okay, so when that's just kind of semi-dissolved, we're not going to really worry about it because it's going to dissolve anyway as it cooks, I'm going to start to add my flour. Now, I'm not going to add the flour all at once. You're going to add it a little bit at a time. Now, you're going to get some lumps with this, but don't worry about it.
because just like your gravies, this is going to all dissolve out. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and put in, this is my chicken stock. And that's 3 cups of chicken stock. And I'm going to stir this now. Like I said, this has to come up to a boil. And when it comes up to a boil, then I'm going to show you what I'm going to do to it next. Okay, now I'm going to add to my chicken stock, I'm going to add my milk. And that's going to be 1 cup of milk. Now there is my milk going in. Now I'm going to bring this up to a boil as it thickens. And once it comes up to a boil, I'm going to bring you back and I'll show you exactly what it looks like. Now as you can see now, the flour has to disintegrate. So I'm going to stir it. That should take about 5 minutes for it to come up to a boil. Once it comes up to a boil, I'll bring you right back. Be right back. Okay, now we're back and I need you to look at the sauce. See how it got? And that's only when you bring it to a boil. Once you bring it to a boil, it thickens. So see how thick it is? So this is the exact consistency that you want in order to make this dish. Don't worry about it. As soon as it starts to boil, it's going to start to thicken. Now, you're going to take this mixture and you're going to put it into your chicken and your vegetables. Okay? So, I'm going to pour a little bit. I took a little bit of my chicken out because I want to make sure that I had enough sauce because mine is oversized. So I want to make sure that I had enough sauce in order to cover it, which I do. So I'm going to take the rest of my chicken and my vegetables and just put it on back in there. Now you can taste this, the sauce, and make certain that it's seasoned to perfection or like you like it. Okay? I'll put just a little bit more. You can always save it if you have some extra. Put just a little bit more in there. Ooh, cut my stove off. Okay. Okay, now I've mixed everything together. And you see exactly how it is. This is exactly how you want it when it bakes off, okay? If you like a little bit more, if you like a little bit more of the sauce, you can add a little bit more of the sauce. But I really think that this is enough. Okay. And you can always take the sauce and use it at a later date. Okay. So now I'm going to take this. And I'm going to put it down into my baking dish. Now, you know I've already put that perforated part in it. And I left just a few holes. Okay, so now I'm just going to pour this in. I believe in trying to use up everything that I have. So once I pour that into my bowl, then you're going to get ready to put your top on it. Sit that over. This looks really good. Okay, so you're going to spread it all out into your baking dish. You can use whatever vegetables you have. It's not set that you have to use mixed vegetables. Whatever vegetables you have in your house and whatever meat you have in your house. Because you can make it a beef pot pie. You can make it a chicken pot pie. You can make it a turkey pot pie. You can make it anything with the meat that you have left over. Okay? So now I'm going to take the top that I have, already put together. Get it over here sooner enough. And then I'm going to put the top layer on it. Okay. So I'm going to take this. And I'm going to spread it. I'm going to get a knife. And then I'm going to cut the ends of this. Okay. Alrighty. Now you're going to custom fit it yourself. That's easy to do. Just take a knife and just cut it along your edges. Now, if you're the type of person that you like a lot of crust, then you can go ahead and keep that. But if you just want your tops to be covered, if you want to keep it, then just fold it over. But if you just want your tops to be covered, then just cut it off. Okay. I'll cut just some of this off. Okay. I'll smash it down. Now what you want to do so that this pie will be able to breathe is you want to poke holes in it. You see some perforated holes already over here, but on this side you don't see any. So I'm just going to go ahead and poke it. Okay. So once I get this poked all over so that the steam can come out, then I'm going to go ahead, and I could have decorated, cut it, but I didn't even think about that. My family's just going to eat it, so whichever way that you do it, there, that looks a little bit better. Then you just go ahead and cut it. Now that everything is sealed up, I'm going to put it in my oven, and I'm going to bake it at 425 degrees. I'm going to bake this for roughly 30 to 35 minutes until it's bubbly and until my top is actually golden brown. So what I'll do is I'll stick this in my oven 35 minutes. I'll be right back. So there it goes. See you in a few minutes. Okay, now we're back and I'm gonna take it out of my oven because it looks to me like it's done. There it is. Okay, and if you can see, makes a little bit of difference when you put a little design in it, like I did there. But if you can see around the sides, I'm going to try to hold this up. If you can see it's baked all on the bottom. And that's the top of it. Okay, so it's all done. I'm going to wait about 10 minutes before I cut this. If you want to rub a little butter on yours, you can. I'm going to leave this pretty much like it is, and I'll bring you back in 10 minutes. I'll cut it, and then I'll dish it up. Be right back. Okay, now we're back, and it's cooled just a little bit, and I did just go ahead and put some butter on top of it. I just couldn't resist that. It's not cooled an awfully lot, probably about 6 minutes. I do want to tell you, so I'm going to go ahead and dish this up, but I do want to tell you that I did try to get some out. Oh my goodness, this looks really, really good. Oh man, and that crust is really, really good. Look at the vegetables in there, how it came up. I do want to tell you, started to talk and then I stopped. I do want to tell you that this is a one dish, okay? You have your bread, your vegetables, and your meat inside. Now, you can serve this with a salad if you like, or you can serve it exactly like it is. So I wanted to just pull that back so you'd be able to see it. That's the crusty part, which is the good part of any chicken pot pie. And then, see, you don't have a lot of gravy, and this is all you really need. You don't want it to be too juicy. If you do, you could just use all of it. If not, you could just leave it like it is. So that's what I have for you today. Chris is making chicken pot pie.
Okay, I hope you will try it. I think you will really enjoy it. I think your family will enjoy it as well. And like I said, it's only one dish, so that's easy cleanup. And as always, thank you for watching Chris Cook for YouTube. Bye.